I liked it better when you didn't talk.
That was my dream. My dream in life was to one day have the first place Mr. Olympia trophy in my hands.
How's that look?
Does that fit?
All right, goddammit, I am out of real food. No! Shit. So, it's not a very good fucking morning for me, goddammit. So, anyway, good fucking morning, everyone. I hope you're having a better morning than me. Shit. So, I guess breakfast is gonna be fucking pasta and meatballs is gonna be my breakfast. So, I guess since I'm Italian, I can go ahead and fucking eat spaghetti and meatballs for breakfast, right? That's acceptable. But that's okay. I'll be fine. I can't believe I'm out of real fucking food. Last time I thought I had about 12 fucking, at least 12 fucking containers of it. I don't know where it went. But I've been eating that shit like crazy. I eat for breakfast, 4 scoops for breakfast, and then another time usually before I train, and then again 4 scoops after I train. So I guess I'm just going through it like crazy. So I guess I'm stuck with meatballs and pasta this morning, and I gotta get some more real food. And the problem is I have to fucking call and get the shit sent to me, so I'm not gonna get it for, what, 3 or 4 days, so I'm gonna be fucked. But anyway, so I just got back from the Olympia. It was an awesome fucking weekend, and, you know, I have the time of my life at every expo, and it's just non-stop, just fucking fun. I mean, I can't even explain how much fun I have. I got there Friday morning, and it was just non-stop until Sunday night, you know, and then I got home. It's Monday morning. I woke up early, ready to start the day. It's like 5 a.m., which normally I don't get up this early. Normally, I don't get up till between 6 at the earliest and, you know, maybe sometimes not till 8 o'clock. I don't set my alarm. I just get up when I get up, and I average probably between 4 and 6 hours of sleep is usually what I average a night. I prefer 8, but usually I'm too busy. So I got up this morning wide awake, ready to start the day, which is crazy because I killed myself all weekend, nonstop on my feet, you know, from morning till 2 in the morning every night. Didn't get to sleep till 2. Got up probably 6 a.m. and, you know, all day fucking killing at the booth, killing at the gym. We'd all go eat. You know, we had over 60 athletes at the booth, so it was fucking huge. And we go out to dinner and have over 30 people. You know, we go to the gym, we walk in with over 30 people. And it was just an awesome time. And I got to meet so many fucking cool ass people. And I get to see so many people that I haven't seen for a year. I haven't seen them since last year. Now, what's crazy is it seems like it's only been a couple months, right? It doesn't seem like a fucking year went by. And, you know, you see the people and it seems like you just talked to them a couple months ago. And it's like, fuck, I haven't seen you in a year. Jeez, what happens to time? It just flies by. So anyway, the Olympia is over now. It's back to the grind. I had an awesome time, and I gotta be honest, I didn't get to make it to the Olympia fucking, you know, the Saturday night show. I didn't make it because we were filming videos with my athletes, and we got some, you know, I had an opportunity to get some great video in, and I wanted to do that, so that was the priority. But, you know, my predictions were wrong for Olympia, so I was hoping, you know, we're going to get a new Mr. Olympia and have some fucking excitement going on, but that didn't happen. But hey, I got to say, Phil, he deserved that shit without a doubt. He looked fucking incredible, you know, and it was definitely, you know, there was no way you could say he didn't deserve it. I mean, hands down, he was the clear-cut winner. You look at the scorecards and, you know, he got first place all across, prejudging first place all across the night show. So there was no doubt in the judge's mind. Every single judge had him first place. And so congratulations to Phil. You know, he fucking killed it again. He came in, he probably looked the best he's ever looked, which is awesome. That's how it's supposed to be. And you know, my boy Leveroni, you know, he accomplished incredible. I mean, what he did was unfucking believable. Now, he didn't win, he didn't place, but you know, he did look insane, and I'm hoping that he's going to do it again next year. I hope he's going to keep training hard and keep pushing, and hopefully going to do it next year. And I think he can make some insane progress from now until next year, and be a front runner for next year's Mr. Olympia. I mean, so hopefully that's what he's going to choose. I guess we'll wait and hear it from him. But I'm getting ready to start my day and get to the gym and get back to my fucking killing in the gym. You know, when I'm away at expos, I go to the gym every single night after the expo, but you know, it's, I really can't train because, you know, I'm meeting people, talking to people, taking pictures, and that's what I enjoy doing. So I don't even go to the gym with the intent to fucking get a good workout. And I go to the gym with intent to meet more fucking awesome people, you know? And we were at City Athletic Club Friday night, and it was insane. It was fucking packed, and everyone in there was fucking training hard. People were doing, you know, video shoots, so it was really inspiring, and I had a great time. And you know, it was all around a great fucking weekend. So it's back to the grind, back to training hard, back to making videos, you know, back to work basically until the next expo. But the expos for me is, it's my time to just fucking have a great time, you know. And I'm working the whole time, but it's fun, you know. And there's nothing better than enjoying what you do, you know, loving what you do, not enjoying what you do, literally fucking loving what you do, you know. And I definitely love what I do, and I love making videos. I love motivating people, and you know, I want to educate and teach people, you know, things that I wish was taught to me when I was young and upcoming in the sport, you know, things that I didn't realize, things I weren't aware of. And you know, that's my whole premise, guys. My whole premise is honestly just to make videos, inspire, motivate people, and educate people, and that's it, you know. And you know, there's absolutely never any negative. It's always positive, it's always motivational. And I you know, I really wish that everyone else would learn and, you know, stay positive, you know, stay positive in every way, shape, and form. There's no reason to be negative. And you know, the glass is always half full, and whenever you look at anything, you can either find the positive or find the negative. And you know, it's, you'll be so much happier and you'll enjoy life so much more when you're being positive and you're looking for the positive. And you know, my life has been phenomenal, and I've changed a lot, you know, in the way, just as a person. And you know, mostly it's been, you know, just becoming a more positive person, and you know, thinking positive, and you know, in every single aspect of life, you know, you can find that positive. You know, negative shit happens to us all the time, but you got to turn it into a positive. You know, whatever it is in life, you can flip it and make it a good thing, you know. And a lot of times, you know, things might happen for a reason, and you could look at it that way and you know, turn it into a positive and be happy with the situation, you know. And that's pretty much everything in life. So anyway, I hope you guys can take that advice, be positive, and keep pushing forward. And you know, the people out there that are negative, that you know, all they have is negative shit to say, those are people that are unhappy, you know. And that's why everything comes out negative. So stay positive, people, and stay happy, and keep pushing forward to meet your goals. And I'm gonna have an incredible day today. I gotta catch up with a lot of shit that I didn't do over the weekend because I was at the Olympia. A little behind, you guys. I've been a little behind in videos, so I'm gonna get this shit rolling. And first thing I gotta do is eat these fucking meatballs and get my ass to the gym, have a great fucking workout, and just continue on. So anyway, guys, I hope you have a great fucking morning. It is package time, like Christmas every day. I have no idea what this shit is. This one's from 5%. Oh boy, presents every day, goddammit. Okay, this doesn't look like something I would fucking want. What the hell?
Oh, it's my sweater. They sent me my sweater.
What the hell? I didn't even know we're still selling these. These are like old school hoodies, right?
It's my favorite.
I didn't really have that shit anymore. I haven't seen these forever. But, is this another one?
Oh, that's the passion one. I love the passion one with all the pink. It's so pretty.
This is, what the hell? This is all your shit. So you getting shits in here now too? Oh, brother. Okay. All right, hopefully this is some shit for me. Yeah! 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 the hell is this? Whatever it is, it's fucking leaking.
Oh no, it's my self-tanner.
Self-tanner. Oh, brother. Alright, I guess this is all your shit. So much for fucking Christmas time. God damn it.
Well, it's Christmas for me.
Yeah, I guess so. Meal two. And I'm eating the same fucking thing. Fucking pasta, rigatoni with fucking meatballs. Fucking second time today. Hey, if it's fucking good, if it ain't broke, why fix it, right? So, my fucking camera girl doesn't eat carbs, so she eats all the fucking protein and fucking leaves the pasta. So, I guess I'm gonna maybe have double pasta today, which probably isn't the best idea. This one was chicken Alfredo, so the pasta gonna be good as fuck. And then look what I got for dessert. This was from Protein House in Vegas. I know you guys know Protein House. So this is some kind of fucking chocolate protein, I don't know, brownie or muffin. And these are macadamia nut fucking cookies from Protein House in Vegas. So that'll be my breakfast. We stopped by there after the Olympian, got a shitload of food to fucking bring home because it's so good. So if you guys never been to Protein House in Vegas, you gotta check it out. Larissa Reese, what's up? And Andy, what's up? But awesome place, started franchising. And they just opened a new one, I can't remember where, Colorado or somewhere, but it's pretty sick. Pretty awesome business. So, I have a premiere tonight to go to right here. It's the premiere of the movie Too Big for the World. What it is it's a movie done on female bodybuilding, and you know, it talks about, you know, how they pretty much got rid of female bodybuilding, you know, and all these women that have been doing it and love it and been involved, you know, kind of are fucked because, you know, all of a sudden there's no more women bodybuilding. And also, you know, I think it goes into detail about, you know, how, you know, the world and, you know, everyday people, you know, frown upon women with muscles, you know, and how frustrated it is for them to work so hard, you know, to develop their body, you know, and people just say negative shit to them, you know, all the time when they go out in public, which I think is, you know, somewhat of a common occurrence, which is, you know, just shows all the fucked up people out there, you know. But I'm actually in the movie. And that's why I got free tickets to the premiere, but I hate to say it, I'm not gonna be able to go because I'm just so fucking busy with everything else going on and, you know, getting ready to move and, you know, just figuring out what I'm gonna bring to Florida, what I'm gonna leave here. And just so much shit, I don't have time to make it. It's in Beverly Hills, you know, it's gonna take up probably 3-4 hours of my day. So I felt bad because I really wanted to support the movie. I really wanted to be there and, you know, I feel awful. I really wanted to go, but anyway, you guys, if you haven't seen it, you got to check it out. Too Big for the World, and I'm sure it's going to be on DVD, Netflix, you know, wherever. But it's probably going to be some pretty good shit. So, finish my fucking meal and get going on the shit I need to work on. And I'm so fucking behind on everything. What's up? God damn it, we are on our way to the gym. Fucking kill it. And it's a little late. A little late getting to the gym today. Fucking catching up on videos and doing shit around the house. So, but what the, is this thing gonna keep fucking beeping or is it shut off?
Well, yeah, if you put your seatbelt on, it'd probably stop beeping, you know.
Yeah, no shit. Jesus Christ. Obviously I'm not driving my fucking car. Shit. What the fuck is that?
I don't know.
So I'm gonna be training my fucking arms, killing them. I'm in a fucking good mood, and I'm gonna have a crazy ass, like 2-hour fucking workout. I'm just gonna fucking destroy them, forearms too. And I've been killing my forearms. I've been
killing my calves and killing my forearms. I've been training, again, training calves every fucking day. But I've been training forearms every day too. So I'm fucking obsessed. I'm on a mission. Yeah, I just ran a red light. And I'm trying to get my fucking forearms just fucking monstrous. Just the craziest fucking forearms. Bigger than my fucking neck. I've always wanted forearms the size of my neck. And I've trained them pretty hard, I'd say, my whole life. But now I'm just going to take it to a whole nother level. And I'm just going to train the fuck out of them every day. Heavy shit. And see what happens. See what I can do. Oh, and I'm starving. I haven't even got to the gym. Fuck, I only ate. I think I only ate 3 fucking meals today. And so now I'm about to train, and then that means I'm only gonna have like 4 meals altogether. Fuck! To have a big motherfucking meal. My last meal is gonna have to make up for 2 meals, maybe 3. Sounds good to me. God, it's so fucking windy. Blowing the fucking car back and forth. Feel that shit? Jesus Christ. Oh man.
Hey, what's up, guys? I'm here with the man, Danny Hester. Mr. fucking Olympia, he fucking did that shit, fucking pulled it off, and I'm just in here giving him shit. He didn't come to my booth and say what's up. He was in Vegas.
I had a little show I had to do, you know.
But I said, you know, he had to do a show, give him a little slip. He won the show. I was saying, if you didn't win the show, then I'd really be giving you shit. But since you won, and you're the top of the top of the top of the top, the top of the top, like number one in the world, right?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll let you slide. We're at North Hollywood Gold. He's been popping in here lately. Been training, right? Like to him. I shouldn't say that because now people don't know.
No.
Now you don't have a hideaway. I just spoiled your hideaway.
Yeah, I was telling the kid at the front desk, man, everything. Everybody trains here. Right? It's like a little gold mine that I found because I never really came here. It was just, I looked up golds because I didn't want to drive to Golds Venice all the time because I lived in the valley. And it's such a blessing to be able to just pop in here like 10 minutes away from my house to get my extra hour cardioing in the morning and at night. And I knew Rich Train here and a couple other people, you know, that are high caliber. So it was motivating to me. I knew it wasn't going to be like a 24-hour fitness. So, you know, thanks to Rich, got the extra, I think the extra hour of cardio that I probably went to did or skipped a lot of times because I had to drop the Golds Venice is what kind of helped the win. So.
Yeah, you were just fucking dragging yourself in here the last couple of days. You didn't talk to no one. You're on the treadmill like this, zoned out. How was it feeling for you?
It's working.
Oh, fuck yeah, dude. That's awesome. So now you're about to go travel all over. And
yeah. I got a lot of kids.
Big things.
Yeah. Definitely don't have to diet for a while. At least not that long.
Until next year, probably.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
Well, I mean, to be honest, I'm not thinking about doing it next year. I'm just gonna stay in shape and I'm gonna grow. I was growing so like well, even getting ready for a show, my weight was going up.
Right.
And I lived the bodybuilding lifestyle from it, which I really wanted this. It's the first time my mom's ever seen me compete in 25 years of competing. Yeah, she's 80 years old.
Wow.
She finally went and watched, and when I won, she was in the front row crying. It was just like,
I've seen you personally at least 10 times in
here. Yeah. You know, and I kind of have, I don't want to say half-assed, but I didn't, like, take it so, like, you know, if I won, I won, whatever. I just wanted something cool to keep myself in shape. And,
right.
Because, you know, for me, there wasn't really a family goal. What am I going to do? You know, guys like you, like these monsters and stuff. And, you know, for my clients, I train a lot of, like, celebrities and world champion fighters. That if I was to get too big, they probably wouldn't hire me.
Yeah.
Because there's a weird intimidation factor that they don't know.
Rich
could probably do the splits and everything, but you know, just the concept in their head, they think, well, I don't want to be like that, so I'm not going to hire that. So I always kind of had to stay in that range. You know what I mean? So when they came out with this classic physique, I mean, that was like what I am already. I didn't have, yeah. have to really
you
do
always
it.
Have been.
Just basically getting in easy condition because I knew if I was going to lose, it wasn't going to be for shape or size, it was going to be conditioning. So I really just buckled down on my diet. Put my ass in the cardio. That's what it did.
Yeah.
It was. I mean, I saw the judges' faces. All the judges have been judging for the last 25 years on that panel. I walked out there, their jaws dropped. They never seen me in that condition. I've never seen it. I want to do selfies on just my ass. Shredded glutes. I'm like, what the hell is that?
Right, right. We were just talking like a month ago, and you were talking about how you can't get shredded glutes.
That's right. Look. Seriously.
I remember.
I just didn't dig deep enough, I guess.
Right. Yeah, well, I mean, this guy has looked the same, I mean, as far as flawless for the last, I've known you 25 years. This guy is always in shape, always looks insane, always ready to step on stage, and fucking crazy. And now he did it. Now he's Mr. Olympia.
Biggest show in the world. The first time I really dug deep and my mom was there, so it could have been more perfect.
Oh, that's awesome.
You know?
Yeah.
So I was real happy.
Well, happy Thanks. For you, brother.
Thank you so much.
Is that going to be cardio now?
This is my first cardio session, actually.
Oh, you do cardio?
Yeah, I got like photo shoots next week. And then last 5 days, I've been eating ice cream. And I can't even go and get gas without eating cookies and candy. It's insane.
You're obsessed.
Yeah.
Obsessed.
Today was kind of the first day where I just stopped.
And I'm sure you're still just fucking shredded, flawless. Veins everywhere.
I got a couple of lines in my glutes still. But I got a cool jacket out of it.
No, that's sick. That's sick. Collector's item.
Yeah. Isn't that something?
Yeah, that's cool, man. That's awesome.
I guess I got that if I didn't win.
Yeah, that's awesome.
The trophy's really cool. I should bring it in. It's really heavy.
Oh, okay.
The metal.
Yeah. Heavy, right? Yeah, it's good quality. So.
It's gold plated.
It's good, man. Usually we get cheap shit for all the contests we've had, right?
Yeah, that's exactly what I was saying. I was thinking that stuff would be plastic or something.
Right, right.
I mean, given when I finally got my pro card, it was a piece of paper.
Right, oh, God. And you had to pay for it.
Yeah. At least they can make it like a metal, like a black card or Amex card or something.
Yeah, exactly. Like the Black like American Express.
Worse than a Social Security card.
Shit.
Yeah,
that's crazy. That's sick, brother. Yeah, I like to see that trophy, man.
Yeah, that's such an ass. I'm like, check out my trophy. I got one.
Oh, shit. That's crazy, dude. That's crazy, man. Yeah, I didn't even see it. Oh, my God. That shit's heavy as fuck, dude. I'm scared to hold it.
That's what I'm saying.
I'm scared I'm going to drop it.
Plastic or something.
No, that's crazy.
I can actually have a beer.
That's what you should have did. That should have been the victory.
You think Richard could bring out a beer?
Yeah, this would be it. This would be my beer. How's that look? Does that fit?
Yeah, that's the
sick. Oh, fuck, dude. Oh, that's sick.
It's solid, huh? It's heavy.
Yeah, it's nice. There it is, goddammit. I gotta say, this is the first time I've ever held Mr. Olympia trophy.
Yeah, isn't that cool?
That's the first place.
Yeah.
That was my dream. My dream in life was to one day have a first place Mr. Olympia trophy in my hands. So I guess I accomplished my fucking dream. Thanks to Danny.
Yeah, I ran out, when they did this to me, I ran out real quick because I didn't want to take it back to somebody.
Right.
Some technicality or something, my first certificate or who knows.
Right.
I've always kind of been a little black sheep of the IFBB anyways. So it was kind of nice that they actually gave it.
That's awesome.
Thank you.
Sick.
Keep at it, man. No matter what people say, or just, it's just, you got to believe in yourself and just keep doing it. If you love it, just do it. Good thing.
Never give up on that shit.
There's a place, a spot for all of us. You know what I mean? It might not be like the normal spot, but get in somewhere if you love what you're doing.
Yep. Find it and make it happen. Right on. Awesome, brother. Awesome. Congratulations. Wow. Sick. That's fucking sick.
just fucking killing fucking arms, and I don't have a shake. I'm out of real food, goddamn it. I have no real food. So I came to the gym with no shake. So when I don't have a shake, what do? Well, here's your answer. I bought a fucking Isopure and a fucking Cliff Bar. And that's my fucking substitute. Is it a good substitute? It'll work. It'll get me by. So I'm gonna drink this, eat this, and on my way to get some fucking food. Some fucking serious food. Grub and grow. So this will get me by until I get the real food in my fucking mouth. So anyway. It's close to oatmeal. It's got some oatmeal in there. Just never mind those fucking chocolate chips, right? It was an accident I got the chocolate chip on. We are on our way for our food run. Starving. Had an awesome workout. And now I'm starving. And guess where we're going? We're going to the Habit. You would have never guessed. Actually, truth be told, we were planning on going to sushi, but we got fucked because we worked out too long and the place we wanted to go was closed. Well, it had, god damn it, are you fucking kidding me with this shit? So then we went to another place and it was closed. So we've had someone didn't want us to have sushi tonight, so we're stuck with the Habit. But sure we'll live, right? And then last night, we got the Habit, and I felt like having fucking bread instead of lettuce wrap, and they were out of every fucking bread they have. Out of sourdough, out of fucking wheat roll, out of sesame fucking roll. Are you kidding me? So I had to have lettuce wrap. I'm like, Jesus Christ, the first fucking time I want to have fucking bread instead of lettuce wrap, they're fucking out of bread. So someone fucking... didn't want me to have carbs last night. Someone didn't want me to have sushi tonight. So I'm gonna try to have bread tonight. See what happens. Oh man, I'm starving. And I'm having fries. I'm having fucking bread and I'm having fucking fries. Extra crispy, no salt. Cause that's the way I like it. Fuck does that mean? This goddamn fucking car is always talking to you. I don't know what the fuck it's saying, but it's always talking. Right. We are here. God damn it. Show them the Habit, god damn it. Oh yes. We're undercover. No one knows it's us in this car. I think I know what you want. You want two, right? One for today, one for tomorrow? Or just one? You can fucking talk already. There's fucking cars behind me waiting.
Did they put mayonnaise on the tri-tip or no?
Yes.
Okay, that was no mayonnaise.
How are you?
I am good, how are you?
Going great, thank you for asking. How can I help you?
Can I get a tri-tip sandwich on sourdough?
Okay, would like any sauce on it, barbecue or teriyaki?
Barbecue.
How about onions? We have grilled onions or raw onions.
Grilled onions.
You said on sourdough, correct?
Yes.
Mayo, lettuce, and tomatoes are okay?
Yep.
And it's also going to be cooked medium. We like it more on the well-done side or medium is okay?
Medium is good.
And we'd like to add fries, anything to drink with your order?
Can I also get a... Fuck, what am I going to get? Can I also get a mushroom charburger on mushroom, sourdough?
Mushroom char on sourdough?
And can I get extra mushrooms?
Okay.
And can I add bacon to that?
Mayo, lettuce, tomatoes, pickles, Swiss cheese.
Yes, please.
Okay.
And
mushroom burger, extra mushrooms, and add bacon.
Right.
Okay.
Okay, and now can I get a tri-tip sandwich lettuce wrap?
Okay, tri-tip lettuce wrap barbecue?
Yes.
Grilled onion?
Yes.
Cooked medium is okay?
Yep. And on that one, no mayonnaise.
No mayo, okay.
Yeah. And then... Gin Club, do you? Or no?
No, I think I want to try a mushroom char burger.
Same thing?
Okay. Lettuce wrap, I think. Is that cool?
And also another mushroom char burger, lettuce wrap.
Okay, mayo, lettuce, tomatoes, pickles, Swiss cheese, and mushroom.
No tomatoes, no mayonnaise?
Exactly.
No mayonnaise, no tomato.
The only Swiss cheese, mushrooms, and the pickles?
Yeah.
Yep.
Okay. I'm sorry, the first mushroom burger, you said it was going to be regular or lettuce wrap?
The first one's on sourdough.
On sourdough, okay. And in the tri-tip on sourdough, so we only have two lettuce wraps so far, correct?
Right.
All right.
And then two orders of fries, extra crispy with no salt.
Okay.
And that will be it.
Nothing to drink?
No, thank you. Oh, did you want one? I'm going to go 7-Eleven.
All right, oh. 7:30 to 45, so enough, please.
All righty, thank you.
Thank you.
Go to 7-Eleven and get that fucking thing I got last time. Fucking half, it was half Diet Pepsi and half pomegranate vitamin water, was it?
Yeah.
A raspberry or some shit. Oh my god, that was fucking pretty good. That was good ass shit, so I'm gonna eat that. Plus it's fucking 48 ounces. This tropical tea, I drink it before we even fucking get home. Then I have nothing to drink by the time we get home to eat. I drank it all. Chipotle's not too dead tonight. Maybe it's picking up a little bit. Still gotta fucking buy the Habit stock. $15 a share, goddammit. And fucking sell short on Chipotle. Right? That's what I keep talking about, and I haven't fucking done it. $15 a share on the Habit. That's just gonna fucking be up in the fucking 50s. Probably in the next year. It's gonna split. Fucking good investment. Everyone, mark my words. Mark my fucking words. $15 a share, Habit stock. Chipotle's going down. Hey.
Hello, how are you doing, boss?
What's up, brother?
So you don't have any lettuce wrap. Well, a couple lettuce wraps. You have a tri-tip on sourdough with barbecue grilled onions, a mushroom on sourdough, extra mushrooms with bacon, tri-tip lettuce wrap, no, only tomatoes and barbecue sauce and grilled onions.
Right.
You have mushroom lettuce wrap, only cheese, mushrooms, and pickles, and two crispy fries, no salt. That'll be $32.45. Thank you.
All right. That's a pretty fucked up order. People are like, what? What are you trying to do? Who orders that shit? I guess half of it's dieting and half of it's don't give a fuck, right?
Vanilla shake, right? Vanilla shake, right? Yes,
vanilla shake. $7.55 and 40.
Can you keep the receipt, brother?
Oh, yeah.
All right, thanks, man.
Thank you.
And for the record, I can't stand the fucking, that what everyone fucking says. No worries. No worries. Hey, can you keep the receipt? Yeah, no worries. Yeah, I hope there's not any fucking worries, motherfucker. You're gonna keep the fucking receipt, right? Everyone says that now. No worries. Hey, sorry, I couldn't make it. Oh, no worries. Well, yeah, I didn't think there was any fucking worries. Is that the stupidest fucking no worries? Hey. Can you keep the receipt for me? Yeah, no worries. Okay, I didn't think you're fucking gonna be. I didn't think I had something to worry about. Am I right or am I right?
Yeah, you're
hey,
right.
Hey, everyone fucking says that. All no worries, no worries. Yeah, no. Of course, there's no fucking worries. Stupidest fucking thing. I haven't had ice cream in fucking a week.
Don't talk to me about how long it's been since you've had ice cream. I have not had ice cream in like a month.
That's your fucking problem.
And those fucking Cobb Smart Bars taste like shit.
The what?
Those stupid Cobb Smart Bars. They're so disgusting.
I barely fucking understand you. Yeah, those taste like fucking water. It's like, what's the point, right? It's like either fucking, either cheat or don't cheat. Either eat the shit or don't eat it. You try to do a half-assed cheat, and it's like, it's not even worth it, right?
No, it tastes like shit. And then you really want the good thing. And then you're just sitting there going, I really, really wish that this was just a giant thing of Ben and Jerry's.
Exactly. I think I liked it better when you didn't talk. Do I have, is there even ice cream in the freezer?
Are you kidding me? It's packed.
That's good. You haven't eaten none of my fucking ice cream. That's a rarity.
Here you go, boss.
Is that everything?
That's it.
Really? All is everything's in there.
You got three, and then you got your mushroom lettuce shrimp in the bag with two fries and no salt, okay?
So four sandwiches all together.
Four sandwiches and two fries.
Right on, brother. All right, have a good one, man.
All right, you too. Thank you.
That blocking the camera?
Just a tad.
Oh my god, I smell those fucking fries. I smell that shit all the way home. You know, it's another pet peeve of mine. I don't know, you might know it.
The fucking beeping noise?
Yeah, that's fucking more than a pet peeve. Look at this asshole. He's gonna try to turn in the fucking exit. What a dipshit. So, you know, like we got the food here. We're driving home, right? Fucking people, they can't fucking wait to get home to eat the food. As soon as the bag fucking comes in the car, they're fucking macking on fries and like have no fucking control, right? That fucking drives me crazy. I don't know why. As soon as you get the food and you hand it over to the person next to you, their fucking hand is in the bag and they're fucking macking fries and fucking eating, and it's like, Jesus Christ, can you wait till we get home? Right? Or people at a buffet and they're getting their food at the buffet and they can't fucking wait till they sit down. They're fucking eating at the buffet. They're walking around, they're fucking eating shit. It's like, get your fucking food, go back to the table. Eat at your table. Jesus Christ. You notice that shit?
Yeah.
Oh my God, you probably do that shit, right?
Guilty as charged.
If you could eat fries, you'd eat them right now.
Not more of an onion ring girl. I don't really like fries.
Fucking buffet. Or people that cook, and while they're cooking, they're fucking shoving shit in their mouth. Licking spoons and fucking... I'm gonna go there. Someone I know very well that fucking does that shit. You know what I'm talking about. It's fucking half the meal's eaten by the time it's cooked. Oh! Yeah, that was the curb. 7-Eleven! God damn it. My camera person doesn't know to show the fucking things we're driving up to. Amateur.
Well. The freaking windshield.
Show the 7-Eleven when we pull up.
Okay, 7-Eleven. Well, the windshield is dirty, okay? You can't really see shit through a dirty
Jesus.
Windshield.
Alright, you wait here?
Yeah.
You wait here. A fucking drink. You want anything? Oh, God. Oh, shit. I don't know if I can take a picture with everyone. I need to get some candy. And my super big gulp, goddammit. Oh my god, those fries are killing me.
The question is,
has been, you know, rich. You know, I'm looking.
What are you doing?
For my future, I'm looking for money.
What do you mean? What am I doing?
What are you eating?
I'm fucking eating ice cream, goddamn.
And what ice cream? Are you eating my ice cream?
What are you doing? 5 minutes ago, you were sound asleep.
You are eating my ice. That is my cheat meal ice cream. You're eating my motherfucking boom chocolate. What is your problem? That is so fucking rude.
What, did you fucking smell the ice cream and fucking wake up?
Yeah, that's my flavor, of course.
Oh my God. There's another one down there.
No, that's the only one. I bought it for myself for a reason. That's my ice cream. You're eating my ice cream. That's my cheat meal.
I don't know what the fuck to tell ya.
Started, you know, focusing.
That's so rude. You're going to take me to the actual Ben & Jerry's store and I'm getting a quart, and then you can't say anything to me about eating the entire quart. I want ice cream.
Ben & Jerry's, we'll get you whatever you want.
No win situation.
Tomorrow we'll get you whatever you want.
So it's hard to get ahead when you're competing by
Well, what am I supposed to do now?
It's not your cheat night now. You just got to sit and fucking watch me eat Ben & Jerry's in front of you. You're not supposed to know. I came in here, so you didn't know I was eating ice cream. And you fucking came in and fucking found me eating ice cream. At least I'm cheating behind your back, right? At least I'm not cheating in front of you, right? At least I'm nice. I'm cheating behind your back. I could be cheating right the fuck in front of you, right?
You're so mean. You are so mean.
Give me some credit. Trying to be respectful. Could be doing that shit right in front of you.
You know, about stopping. I've talked about real estate.
And I'm fucking working. It's like 2 in the morning, man. And I'm fucking still working.
Let's talk about the stock market. Stock market, you're going to need money to make money. Okay? Most people are acquiring.
Well, yeah, it's not like I'm going to sit here and watch you eat my ice cream.
Let me eat my ice cream.
Go back to bed.
You mean let you eat my ice cream?
Let me eat your fucking ice cream in privacy, enjoying my video, and I'll come to bed in a few minutes. Yeah? Sound good?
Yeah.
Go put something sexy on. I'll be in a few minutes.
Truth. Stock market, you need money to make money. So,
eating my fucking ice cream.